Okay, so I really want to thank Eric Avey for taking that time to have an awesome conversation with me after some awesome tacos at a place to eat in Frostburg, Maryland. It was really great to see Mountain Ride, and I want to congratulate them on being booked to be part of the 2018 Charm City Bluegrass Festival. That lineup just came out, and it's awesome from top to bottom, so make sure you check that out. I'll put a link down in the comments here. I'll also have a link to One Place to Go, Mountain Ride's brand new album, and my Spotify playlist, and all that stuff, but I also want to echo Eric Avey's sentiments that the Infamous Stringdusters really represent the future of bluegrass. Not just the awesome way they play, the way they put all their content online with the live streams and the nugs.net downloads and the videos they put on Instagram and Facebook and YouTube and all that kind of stuff, but also the community that they've really established on Facebook and their Got Dusted fan page. And that fan group, the Jamily of theirs, they're such a tight-knit, awesome community, and it really shows the brightest in times of darkness. And they had a really dark time recently when Trevor Wade became one with the Force far too soon, but I wanted to highlight Trevor's impact and really the Jamily community as a whole by including A Hard Life Makes a Good Song. That's a song that was co-written by Jeremy Garrett of the Stringdusters and John Weisberger of Chris Jones and the Night Drivers, and they actually got the inspiration for that song from one of Trevor's Facebook posts. So I think it's really poignant to include as a tribute to him and a tribute to the entire Jamily in such a hard time. It's that kind of connection between the bands and the artists and the fans that really makes the Infamous Stringdusters and this kind of progressive bluegrass music so special. So right now I want to take it back to Blue Ox 2017, thanks to the Infamous Stringdusters and Jamgrass TV, and say, how you guys doing, Dusters?